Zoo by Denzel Curry. Denzel Curry is back with his follow-up album to Taboo, entitled Zoo. Being one of the brightest young stars to come out of Florida, what does he have in store for his fourth studio album? Here's our honest review of Zoo by Denzel Curry.
Boy got hype.
Yeah, he did.
He got hype. You know he's on tour with Billie Eilish?
A word?
Yeah. I just found out because she has a show coming to Atlanta in July or something
you
like
going?
That. Oh, no. I just thought that was kind of cool. I was like, oh, that's cool.
Why you say no like that?
I don't think a crowd would be for me. I don't know.
Yeah,
I might
know,
get
man.
Lost in that crowd.
They might drop some spiders.
I ain't with that.
Into the crowd. How you feel about this album artwork, man?
Yo, man, I guess it's just that, you know, it's just that pose. I think it fits the album because I feel like this is just something that you will go around and drop top listen to.
Yeah,
I mean, that's what it is.
He got the ambitious ace pose.
Oh, man, chill.
He got the ambitious ace pose. He on the old school car. Got the Marlins jersey on. Like, he just represent Florida to the fullest.
Yeah.
That's the kind
got
of the vibe.
Got the colors, too, right?
Yeah. Yeah, that's the Miami U colors for the Denzel Curry and the Zoo in the font. The flow of this project, man, I felt like this was kind of like a wave of, like, what new Florida sound is going to sound like.
Okay.
You know, he was paying tribute to Trick Daddy, Rick Ross, Trina, and kind of like hit on some of those old things. I even got like a little bit of, like, I guess, ode to Juvie. But it, even though Juvie's not from Florida, I don't want people thinking I think he's from Florida.
Right.
You know, got to say that. yeah, it seemed like he was just kind of taking a new take on what Florida music sounds like. And I even caught a couple vibes from XXXTentacion, who was one of his good friends.
Yeah, man, it was definitely a new wave kind of feel. Like, I felt like, oh, this is the sound that we're going for. And, like, just for the album to have just that tight flow, I didn't feel like it deviated from that sound at all. So, yeah, real tight Florida sound. It was really dope.
Zoo caught my attention right off the bat. I thought Birds featuring Rick Ross, I felt like the beat had this like weird distortion electric feel to it, which is really dope. Yeah. Rick Ross went in there with the same pocket you've been hearing him use since he first came out, but it works.
It works.
It always works. Speedboat. I don't know what it is about that joint, but I really like
Speedboat. Does it remind you of anything?
Nah.
Any beat?
Nah.
Can we throw it out there?
What?
Remind me of Bad and Bougie.
You think so?
Yeah. It has that flow. I'm not trying to say it mimics the song or anything like that, but it kind of has that feel, especially when he starts rapping and how the beat's going. Listen to it again.
I have to do that because I didn't get the Bad and Bougie vibe.
I'm not trying to, and don't get this twisted. I'm not trying to say he's mocking or, you know, trying to do it, but I'll just say it just had that similar kind of flow and feel. Take it easy.
All right? Shake 88. That joint is hard.
Hard.
Oh, man, that joint was hilarious, man. Yeah. Just listen to it. If y'all ain't heard it, listen to it. You're going to get a good laugh in there.
Yeah.
I don't even want to spoil it for you if you haven't heard it. And, those are my highlights.
Zoo, I mean, it started the album off really hard. I mean, especially with the Majin Buu reference. I was geeking out.
Yeah, that was funny.
That was funny. Ricky, yo, that beat is hard. It's just a nice ride.
A
word, I'm going to have to check that out. Nice ride to it. Wish, I thought him and Kid Omarv, that's what it is. I thought they did a great job. I thought they bounced off each other really nicely. Birds was really, really dope with Rick Ross coming in at it. I was really feeling Speedboat just because of just how his flow was on the song. And Carol Mark, is it Carol Mark? Yeah, Carol Mark. I thought that was really dope. Shake 88 was fire. And yeah, those are my highlights.
I didn't like Ice Billionberg on
Carol
Mark.
Okay.
I wasn't feeling that. And the skits were annoying as hell.
Yo.
That one was funny.
That was hilarious.
That skit was funny. Because there are just the idea of somebody only using one word in the whole conversation.
Yeah.
Just saying it in different ways.
Yeah.
Not like group.
Yeah.
aside from that, though, it was just something about Wish that I didn't like, and I'm drawing a blank on what it was.
Okay.
But I could tell you that I don't like skits, and like a lot of skits, and then especially when you have skits, you have a something that's called an interlude, but you don't
before
even mention
skit,
the fact there's a skit.
Yeah. So it was like two, like, in a row. Yeah, yeah.
It was just too much, and it's just like I felt like it was more skits than it was music at one point.
Okay.
I mean, technically it wasn't. I'm just over exaggerating, but you get what I'm saying.
Yeah, I wasn't feeling Automatic. I thought it was okay. It was cool. And then, like you said, with the skits, like, you know, the Bushy being interlude, I wasn't feeling that. But Yo was great. I liked that skit. And P.A.T., I thought it was cool. But, you know, the end on that, it was kind of like, I think the vibe was dope because, you know, it went out on a high energy level. But it didn't end, like, strongly as I like, you know, what came before it. So it's not like a bad track. I just didn't feel like it ended strong.
Yeah, look, final thoughts on this joint, man. Denzel Curry, man, he definitely got some twerking music up here. He's got some, I mean, he's got some, twerkers. Like, he's got, like, some borderline, like, metal-ish,
yeah,
you know, vibes here. He's got some hip-hop vibes here. He's got some kind of cool guest appearances. And I guess he's, like, kind of, like, holding Florida down, man. So it's cool to see him come back after Taboo and change the sound up. Yeah. Like, because he didn't just do the safe route and just put out Taboo again.
Yeah, I think with this, it really shows us how versatile he is with his music and the fact that he can, you know, turn around, do a whole nother sound and just knock it out the park, in my opinion. And just, you know, kind of pay homage to, like, the sound of Florida and do his own thing with it. I think it's really, really dope because I think he's crafted something here that anybody can just pick in and play, pick up and play and just be like, oh, this is dope. You know, it doesn't take that much to analyze or anything like that. You can just hop right into it.
Final grade, man. Look, yo, I'm gonna give Denzel Curry a check, man. I thought this was a good follow-up to Taboo. It's unique. It doesn't sound like all his other music, man. He's taking some chances. He's got some really funny, you know, anime references. He has some really fun references throughout this project that kind of had me giggling from here to there.
Yeah.
Like, you know, Ricky just the contradicting things his mom and his dad are kind of telling him.
Yeah.
You know, it was like there's a lot here that's fun, man. You know, Bird, Speedboat, Shake 88. Just listen to Shake 88, man. Just listen to Shake. It's damn near his version of Juvenile Back That Ass Up, but it's really dope.
Yeah.
It's like I almost want to tell you what he says, but you just gotta listen to it. It's funny. It's in the playlist.
Give it a check. Just check it out. You know, you're gonna enjoy this. I mean, I think, you know, regardless of the sound that Denzel Curry does, that I'm learning that he perfects everything. Because, I mean, not to say this is easy, but it seems like he went into this effortlessly. Like, this is just something I think that he knows how to do. And I think that's what you will come away with this project, with the fact that when he has a certain type of sound catered to him, he knows what to do with it and he knows how to execute it flawlessly.